Hi everyone, Alejandro here with Autel Robotics. And in this video, we're gonna go over the general camera settings in the Autel Explorer app. Hopefully by the end of this video, you'll be able to identify, locate, and adjust the necessary camera settings for your project. That way you get the best image possible. Welcome to the flight deck. We'll begin by powering on our EVO II aircraft, our remote controller, and then plugging in our iOS or Android mobile device into the remote controller. Once we open up the Autel Explorer app on our mobile device, we'll tap the camera option, and this will take us to the camera view of our EVO II aircraft. We'll begin with the EVO II Pro gimbal. This is our 6K gimbal, and there are some slightly different options compared to the EVO II 8K. By default, you will be in video recording mode. You can tell with the red record button being on the right-hand side of the screen. We'll now take a look at our video-specific settings down in the bottom left-hand corner of our screen. We'll start off from the left where you see your resolution setting. Here you have the options for 6K, 4K, 2.7K, and lastly 1080p. On the EVO II 8K camera, the video resolution option will also go up to 8K. Depending on your project, you may want to be shooting at a higher resolution, that way you can crop into those images and videos in post-production. Or if you are looking to upload something very quickly, you might want to shoot in 1080p or 4K. Next, we have the frame rate option. These options will vary depending on your resolution setting. For 6K, we have 30 frames per second, 25 frames per second, and lastly, 24 frames per second. If you choose 4K, you'll have the option to set the frame rate going from 60 frames per second all the way down to 24 frames per second. If you choose 2.7K, you'll have the frame rate options of 120 frames per second down to 24 frames per second. And lastly, if you choose 1080p, you'll have the same frame rate options as 2.7K, going from 120 all the way down to 24 frames per second. If your project does require slow motion, you may want to choose a higher frame rate setting such as 120 or 60 frames per second. Otherwise, you can head down to 30 frames per second or 24. Next, we have the format option where we have the option to save our video files in the MOV format or the MP4 format. In today's world, we don't really see much of a difference in between the two formats and whether or not they're OS specific. Depending on personal preference, you may want to save one video file in one format versus the other. Next, we'll move on to our exposure settings. All of these settings are applicable to both of your video and camera options. First, we'll start off with our exposure mode setting. This setting will allow you to adjust how the camera automatically or manually adjusts the rest of your exposure values. If you have it set to automatic, the EVO II's camera will automatically adjust the shutter, the aperture, as well as your ISO values. You will be able to adjust your EV or exposure value setting to adjust the brightness or darkness of your picture, but the camera will do the rest. Next, we have the manual option. This setting allows you, the user, to adjust all of the exposure values manually. So you'll be able to change the ISO, the shutter speed, and the aperture according to your picture. Next, we have shutter priority mode. Shutter priority mode allows you to adjust just the shutter speed and let the camera adjust the rest of the settings automatically. So you won't have to worry about your ISO and your aperture. And lastly, we have aperture priority mode. This is similar to shutter priority mode, but instead you'll have access to change the aperture setting and let the camera adjust the rest of the exposure values. Moving on to the rest of the exposure settings, we have aperture. Aperture is only going to be an available setting on the EVO II Pro gimbal, as the EVO II 8K has a fixed aperture. Aperture is the physical value of how much light you're letting hit your camera sensor. On the EVO II Pro, it ranges from f over 2.8 all the way up to f11. If you were to select f over 2.8, you would be allowing the most light to hit that camera sensor, but you'd be getting the most shallow depth of field. Meanwhile, if you select F over 11, you would be letting the least amount of light hit your camera sensor, but everything would be in focus in your image. Shutter speed is the amount of time that you're allowing the shutter on the camera to stay open and allow light to hit the camera sensor. If you were to choose a shorter time, such as 1 over 8,000, you're allowing less light to come into the camera. If you choose a longer time, such as 1 over 30, you'll allow more light to hit the camera. Be careful when shooting videos that require a lot of motion, as you will see motion blur if you choose a longer time frame, such as 1/30. The next setting is ISO mode. This mode is available in all exposure mode settings except for manual. You have the options between auto and manual ISO mode, which just means that you're either letting the camera automatically adjust the ISO value or you're manually adjusting it yourself. After ISO mode, we have our ISO value. This ranges from 100 all the way up to 6400. The ISO is the camera's sensitivity to light. So the lower the number, the less sensitive it is, the higher the number, the more sensitive it is. So if you were to choose 6400, this would be great for a low light scenario, but it will increase the noise in your image. Next, we have our EV or exposure value setting. This setting is available in every exposure mode except manual. EV is the combination of your ISO and shutter speeds into one number. You can then adjust the number from -3 all the way up to +3. After our EV or exposure value setting, we have our white balance setting. This is used to set the color temperature of your image. Here we have some preset options depending on your specific environment, or we also have the custom setting where it'll allow you to change the Kelvin all the way from 2000 Kelvin up to 10,000 Kelvin. After white balance, we have our digital zoom setting. Here you can digitally zoom into your image up to 8 times. On the EVO II Pro, up to 3x zoom will still keep you at a 1080p resolution on your video. In the autofocus option, you're allowing the camera to automatically focus depending on where you're tapping on the screen. If you tap on the background, you will then focus on the background, and if you tap on something in the foreground, it will focus in the foreground. With the manual focus option, you will be presented with a slider on your screen. It will go from 0 to 50. The smaller the value, closer to 0, it will focus in on the foreground, and the higher you get up to 50, it will then focus in on the background of your image. Next, we have our color profile setting. Here, you will be able to choose from log, black and white, and nostalgic. These profiles will change the look of your image in real time and how they're processed in post-production. If you wanted to do any sort of color grading, we would recommend using the log color profile. Next, we have our style setting. The style setting will allow you to change the contrast, sharpness, and saturation of your image in real time. And lastly, we have our PIV or picture and video setting. This setting allows you to either manually or automatically set an interval at which you're taking pictures while recording video. The manual option allows you to manually hit the shutter button while recording video, or you also have the option to set the interval automatically from 5 seconds all the way up to 60 seconds, depending on how frequently you want the camera to take an image. Those were all of our different video setting options. We're now going to go ahead and move on to the specific camera settings for photography on your EVO II Pro. So we're gonna tap the button below that red record button where you see the small camera icon. You're gonna tap on that. Now you'll see that the camera icon is the larger of the two icons. We can head over to the same area in the bottom left-hand corner and you will now see that those settings have changed. Starting from left to right, we have our size option. This is actually the dimension of your still images. On the EVO II Pro, we have 3 different dimension options: 5472 by 3648, 5472 by 3076, and lastly 3840 by 2160. For the EVO II 8K camera option, your dimensions will slightly differ. You will have 8000 by 6000, 7680 by 4320, 4000 by 3000, and lastly 3840 by 2160. Next, we have our mode setting. This adjusts how your camera is actually taking pictures. By default, it will be set to single, which means that every time that you hit that shutter button on the right-hand side, you're just taking one still image. The burst option will allow you to change the amount of images that your camera takes when just tapping the shutter button once. You have the option to take 3 images quickly or 5 images quickly. Next, you have your time-lapse option. This adjusts the interval that your camera takes pictures based off of time, where you can set it from 5 seconds all the way up to 60 seconds. Your AEB or auto exposure bracketing option allows you to take 3 images at different exposures or 5 images at different exposures. And lastly, we have our hyperlight option, which is a photo mode that is intended to only be used at night or in low light scenarios. And lastly, we have our format setting. This allows you to change the format in which your still images are saved. We have 3 different options here. We have JPEG, RAW, and lastly, the option to save in both the JPEG and RAW formats at the same time. The JPEG format is a smaller and more compressed file format, allowing for an easy data transfer. The RAW format is raw information coming from your camera, which amounts to a larger file size, but will give you much more flexibility in editing your images in post-production.
That was a brief introduction into our camera and video settings on your EVO II AK and EVO II Pro series aircraft. We hope that you were able to pick up on where some of these camera settings are, what they're good for, and how to use them. Next in the video series, we have our advanced camera settings in the Autel Explorer app. Thank you so much for watching, and so long from the flight deck.